Hi, welcome back to a new episode of the greatest book club in the world. Zayke book club, yeah! And today, guys, we're on extremely special episode because today, guys, one episode number 303, guys. 303? Yeah, guys, we're on 303. So let's go. It's so savage. So guys, if you're new to the channel, welcome, and if you're already familiar with the channel, welcome back. My name is Zach and I'm the host. And on this podcast, guys, we're working together on English speaking level, learning level, and on kind of end, on communication skills to stand in front of the camera and to communicate well from the camera. I'm doing this podcast because I know I'm aware of the fact that sometimes speaking English is might be challenging, and to be in the camera is might be challenging. And I'm aware of it. And I also struggle with this thing. And I'm hoping that with this podcast, I can inspire other people all around the world, maybe you, like you, the ladies and gentlemen that are watching the podcast, maybe you, to also do the same, to also work in English and to speak your truth. That's a share message with the world because it's really important. I truly believe that it's important that you will share your message with the world. Let's see what happens if I put the mic over here. Oh, but it's hiding the screen so I cannot read. But yeah, it looks savage, right? You see my new mic? It looks so savage. I don't know. Maybe if you can do something like this. No, it's still. Was on me. Let's make it back. So anyway, guys. I don't know. I put it in something. Next to my, I think you need right here. If you don't know what it's for, what it's happening with this, never mind. And I hope, guys, that by and what I'm and hoping that guys, by sharing with you guys, monster on my own journey to become a master in English speaking and the learning level and the master on communication on the camera, I will inspire the people to do the same, and you will see that it's not so. It's not terrifying to speak in English, yeah, you also can do it. And you see, I'm 30. It's my birthday, so I'm 30. And I started doing this podcast 1 year ago, a little bit more than 1 year, 1 year and a month, 1 month, 2 months. It's a lot. So you see, it's never too late to start speaking in English, to start to work on English and to work on your appearance on the camera. Guys, I really love the camera quality. It's really, really, really good. I really love it. And I don't know why my green screen doesn't work. It yesterday it didn't work, so I don't know why. Anyway, I really love the quality, so I think I'm going to buy me another camera. I'm going to get another camera. My studio in Ariel. Anyway, guys, a new camera, and I got this mic, and I'm going to buy a new mic for my own studio. Anyway, guys, back to the subject. And I think that by sharing with you guys my own journey, I will inspire other people to do the same. So, guys, I hope you will find this journey inspiring. And today, guys, as you see, this is a winter of fall. I think you call it fall. I got in the fall environment. Because in Israel it's cold. I don't know. I feel cold. I don't know why, but it's really cold to me. And I got this nice vibe of the atom. This is how you call it, atom. It's what comes after the winter. It's atom. Well, the quality of the camera, it's really good. It's really, really good. I really love it. Really, really, really good. So anyway, guys, if you want to check out this kind of background, you know, you can find them 3, 2, 1 cabane. You can find it. Where does this appear? Atom, yeah. You can find them good fun. And this great background upload to good fun by none other than Nanali. On 16 of November 2016, download 1,000 times. Of course, we like it. Does he really enjoy it? And we show of appreciation to the artist. It's also really nice. I like it. Guys, if you want to download the pictures, just need to choose the resolution from here. Press download. Right click on the picture, go to Shmirat Tonight B'Shem in Hebrew, or say Pictures in English, and tap down the camera to write it in your own language. Press on it, and it's all of us, we need to guess from where you are all around the world. It's going to be a really nice game. Press save. You can imagine guys like that, you will get this great background on the computer. So thank you very much for the artist who made this great background for sharing it with us, and thank you very much to Nalini for sharing this great background with us. And today, guys, we are almost finished the book. Today, we are going to finish chapter 15, which is the last episode, the last chapter of Your Next Five Moves, this great book, Your Next Five Moves by Patrick McDavid, Master the Art of Business Strategy. And I really learned a lot from this book. And I really started to strategize my next moves. You know, I got a new job, and I strategize my move in this. If I get the job, and I strategized the moves. If I don't get this job, anyway, I really enjoy the game of planning of strategizing. I really enjoy it. A really good book. So guys, if you want to check out this great background, or if you want to check out the book, or Patrick McDavid social media account, you know that I really recommend to check them out, because on his social media account, Patrick McDavid shows us a huge amount of knowledge. As you saw in the free special episode. You know, you got all the link. You know, we got all the link to it. Yeah, that's right in the description below. So make sure to check them out and like them, like the background, like Patrick McDavid my social media account and the book. And guys, if anyone of you have any suggestion for making for myself or the podcast, or if anyone of you want to go to the podcast, be a guest of the podcast, or some share message of this part of the world, and just have a good time with me in English, because you know I'm a really nice guy. But if the camera right now. Please let me know in the comment below so we can arrange it. And guys, of course, as always, feel free to leave a comment below if you learned something new to the channel, maybe something that I said, or maybe you learned a nice quote from the book, or maybe you have your own life lesson that you learned somewhere else, by your own experience, I don't know from where, that you find interesting and you think that can enrich our life, the community life. Feel free to share it with us, find it to us in the description below, in the comment section below, so all of us. So of us can enrich our life and improve thanks to you. So thank you very much. And guys, one last thing before we jump to the book. If you enjoyed the process, if you enjoyed this episode, you know something new for the channel, and if you want to support the journey, please consider to subscribe to the channel, push the notification bell so you don't forget it on YouTube. That's extremely exciting episode coming to YouTube. I know it's going to be 5 extremely exciting episodes per week. So make sure to check it out. Yeah. Like the video, share it with friends, subscribe to the channel, and push the notification bell. Guys, it's really 1 to 3, 4 clicks from your side, and it's really have a huge impact on me. So thank you very much, guys, if you can consider to do it. And shout out to my 2 subscribers, and my total, I think 260. Let's check it out. So what you say, let's check it out. So let's share screen. Design issues. The AK Book Club. Damn, who is this savage? I know this savage. The AK Book Club, let's see. Yeah, 2 subscribers. And 274, whoa, reviews. Damn, it's a lot, we're growing. And the last episode that was released is 294 special. So yeah, in a week from this day, you see the day today is 16 January 2022. It's Wednesday, and time now it's 21:54. So in 1 week, you are going to watch the special episode, the 300 special episode. Yeah, so it's good for you guys. In the best. I'm so savage, yeah. But I think I need to cut my hair again. You see, from here, I need to cut it inside. Maybe, I don't know, maybe in next month or something, I will do it. So guys, right now, so guys, next now, just diving into the book without an introduction, let's just dive into the book. So next 5 moves by Patrick McDavid, Master of the Art of Business Strategy. Page 236 to 239. Read was the myth of the legend available in the manuscript. Give me some drum, please. Some boy, aka, that's me. Look, you can only see me. I'm gonna leave the camera. I need to buy more. Title, guys, we are back to 245 in the middle of the page because it's a new title and a story. So let's see from there. Leadership title. Leadership is knowing what drives people. In this, our final chapter, we keep coming back to the ideas we have already looked at. And are now taking to the next level. In chapter 2, we talked about knowing what drives you. Now we are going to examine what motivates others. We touched on some of those things when discussing the 9 love languages of entrepreneurs. But this is next level. When I was 22 years old, working at Morgan Stanley Dean Bitters, as an advisor. I spoke to 2 audiences in a span of a month. The first was a group of seniors who wanted to learn about better alternatives for retirement. I spent the majority of my time speaking to them about what it would feel like to be able to live in a 10,000 square foot home with a Ferrari parked outside and then an MX black card in their wallet. They looked at me as if I had lost it, until they stopped paying attention altogether. A couple of weeks later, I spoke to a group of salespeople who were in their late 20s to early 30s and decided to take a completely different approach. I asked them to think about what it would feel like to one day be able to send their kids and their grandkids to the best universities without worrying about how much it would cost, or having enough money in a retirement account to draw $10,000 a month for the rest of their lives. While living comfortably near a golf course. Again, I lost them all. At the time, I had a manager who was trying to motivate me. All she talked about were the things that moved her. As you can imagine, she lost me. When I reflected, it made me realize why I had lost both audiences. Just as she didn't speak to me, just as she didn't speak to what drove me, I hadn't spoken to what drove each audience. The ultimate power move is getting the most out of people. It's also the move that will, now I'm speaking for myself, bring the most fulfillment. Seeing people finally get the light to turn on and succeed is what I live for most. It's also the reason this book is in your hands. A great leader is someone who sets a great example and deems moral authority. A great leader is someone who is able to get others to do things they wouldn't do on their own. There are many people out there who set a great example yet. Still struggle with why their team doesn't follow their example. Setting an example alone is not enough. Great leaders eventually learn how to drive people to their own standard of excellence. This isn't an easy task, which makes it a high-paying skill. Anyone who learns how to move people as a skill set that is transferable to any industry. Again,
let's look at the four areas that drive people. Then we will speak specifically about how to lead those who are driven by each category. The four areas that drive people. Advancement. Next promotion. Completing a task. Meeting a deadline. And reaching a goal as a team. Individuality. Lifestyle, recognition, security. Madness. Opposition. Competition. Control. Power and fame. Proving others wrong. The need to avoid embarrassment. Mastery. Desire to be the best. Break records. Purpose. History. Helping others, change, impact, alignment / self-actualization. Advancement. What drives you changes at each path of your life? Title, advancement. People driven by this see reaching new heights as the best form of motivation. Constantly have the next goal or position set up for them to keep moving up, or they will get bored. Title, Individuality. The language to speak to this group is what their future in life can look like if they give everything they have. Cars, prestige, going to the best restaurants, traveling, associating with celebrities, and so on. As long as they know that the lifestyle they are motivated by can eventually be reached by working with you, they will do their part to help grow the company. Title, Madness. People driven by this see unconventional factors as the best form of motivation. They are driven by having an enemy, by facing an opponent. They will be bored out of their minds if you don't constantly find them a new enemy or target to reach. Title, Purpose. People driven by this want to be part of something bigger than they are, but they also want the history books to write about them. In the company's history books or in industry papers. This group might be the smallest of the bunch, but if you're lucky enough to attract one to your organization, get ready to experience a massive explosion. I think I'm a purpose guy. Title, Understand, Position, and Lead, but do not try to fix. I don't know. No matter whom you are managing. Remember that the fastest way to lose them or frustrate them is to try to change them. I've made this mistake too many times in my career. Instead, find what drives them and position them in a way to win it at the highest level. It might require you to change the lens through which you view them. Stop trying to fix people. Thinking you can change or fix people is a delusional behavior. When I started in a business, I was guilty of this all the time. I pushed people out when they were coming up short, because I assumed that was what they wanted. I figured that if they were messing up, they would appreciate my feedback, harsh as it might have been, and will change and become the performers I needed them to be. This is delusional. I realized that I couldn't change people. They had to possess the inner drive to fix their own mistakes. Once I realized that, I began to manage people more effectively. I stopped trying to solve other people's problems instead. I realized that what they wanted is someone to listen to them, someone to ask them questions, someone to nudge them in the right direction, in the right direction. People want to be heard. Taking the time to understand them is critical for effective leadership. After that, if they possess an inner drive to excel, they will self-correct. They will do their part in achieving their best. By digging deeper into power plays, we now have the different lens for which to view all human interactions. Whether it's leveraging a negotiation or your first meeting with an influencer, taking the time to see where the power lies and acting accordingly is what will make you a grandmaster. If you want to develop this ability, the most powerful move you can make is to shadow great leaders. Whatever the situation, you do your best to be around people who have the skills and the success that you are seeking. Keep the chart of what drives people close by. Remember that everyone is motivated by different things, and that your job as a leader is not to drive them, or worse, fix them. It's to understand them and help align the chess pieces in front of them so they can maximize their potential. Move 5. Master Power Plays. Title: How to Beat Goliath and Control the Narrative. 1. And then identify the next Goliath for you and your company to go after. Create a strategy to control the narrative. Minimize distractions and anything that stands in the way of your beaten Goliath. Title: Study Mobsters, How to Sell, Negotiate, and Influence. 2. Instead of thinking only about what is in front of you, think about how to find wins for your strategic partners. Before the next meeting, go through all 7 steps of preparation. In every negotiation, be aware of who has leverage. Don't over negotiate when you are lacking it, and don't bully when you have it, especially if you view the other person as a long-term strategic partner. Title: Cultivate Your Power and Stay Battle Tested. 3. Constantly study leverage. Watch every interaction between people, cultures, and the business to see if you can determine who has the leverage and if that person or entity is using it to gain power. Also, shift your approach to finding ways to help others rather than using a shotgun approach to getting business. Lastly, value people so deeply that you are constantly looking to see what drives them and how you can help steer them and how you can help steer them based on their motivations. Guys, this is the end of today's episode. And wow, almost finished the book. We have tomorrow episode to finish the book. And tomorrow we're going to start chapter conclusion, checkmate. And after this, guys, we have the, tomorrow we're going to finish the book. And on episode 205, we're going to make the recap. And you know, as always, when we finish the series, we're going to read the book Takedowns and the Best Quotes. That's it, guys. I really enjoyed this episode. And the next book is going to be, we're going to crush it. It's going to be savage. I can't wait to start the next book. And guys, every book that we finish is a little bit sad because unless it's a, you know, which book that I didn't like so much, but I use the book that I didn't like so much. I use this, technique that we learned over him, in him, the most. Yeah, so I enjoy it. But you know, every time that you finish a book, it's a journey. And it's a little bit sad, but it's happy because we finished the task and now we can move on to a new, to learn something new. So guys, thank you very much for joining me. I really appreciate the fact that you choose to invest your time with me. And I can't wait to see you all on tomorrow episode, guys. The next episode of the Grandest Book Club in the World, the AK Book Club, Valentinizen. Have a great time. Take care of yourself and bye-bye. So guys, today it's Wednesday, 16th of June and February 2022. Today it's my birthday. Time now it's 22:11. And yeah, I still have work to do in university, but I really enjoy the episode, guys. I really love it. The new camera, this microphone. Hey. You can hear the microphone. It's making me feel like a professional podcaster. So I really love it. And I'm planning to buy a new microphone to my home studio. And taking this microphone with me to the university. I really love it. And I don't know if it's making a difference in the voice, if it's speaking for me or you. Yeah. I love it. Yeah, I'm going to be... עשר לשני, 2022, עכשיו מלולדת שלי, הייתי בתוך יום 12, עכשיו שמידי ל-16, טוב, זה מלולדת שלי, מלולדת 30, כן, 30, יפה, סיום, כל החיים עוד בפני, השעה היא 10:12 פתאום בערב, יאללה, השנה אנחנו נוצא את הכלבים לטיור, נחזור, נשתקלח, ונשאר עושה שם מוקדם, צריך לקום מחר לקום מוקדם, נעשה לסיים, נתחיל לעבור את המשימה של אייל, מהבקונוי, נסיים אותו היה במוצש, ונראה מה קורה, יאללה, נתראות, ביי.